If you're anything like me, you're probably sick and tired of spending hundreds of dollars at Japanese steakhouses. And that's why in this video, I'm going to show you how to make hibachi chicken at home for a fraction of the cost of what you'd spend at your local teppanyaki restaurant. We'll go over a couple of the most common mistakes I see with almost every recipe online, and then I'll show you how to make hibachi chicken at home even better than any Japanese restaurant you've ever been to. So let's do this. Before we jump into the recipe, I want to go over the most common mistake I've seen with almost every hibachi chicken recipe online. The biggest mistake people make when making hibachi chicken at home is cutting up the meat into small pieces before cooking. While cutting the chicken before cooking does increase the surface area of the meat, which allows it to cook faster, it's really difficult to get a proper sear on such small pieces of meat. When you couple this with the fact that almost everyone crowds their pan, the chicken usually ends up releasing water and boiling instead of getting a proper sear. So to remedy this, we're going to do exactly what they do at most hibachi restaurants and split our breasts into cutlets. Start by taking a single chicken breast half and turning it upside down to see if it has a tenderloin. If it does, it'll look like this. Remove the tenderloin by making cuts down the breast lengthwise. You can use the tenderloin in this recipe if you want, but they don't at most restaurants, so we'll reserve ours for another use. Now trim off the skinny, tapered end of the breast. This will make it much easier to have uniform cutlets. Flip the chicken back over so the smooth side is facing up and place your hand on top, like this. Then make a horizontal cut approximately halfway through the breast. When you've almost reached the other side, open it up, lay it out, and cut directly down the middle, splitting the breast in two. And the finished cutlets should look like this. Then set the fillets aside in the refrigerator until you're ready to cook them. Now, hibachi chicken is typically served with sauteed mushrooms, just your average run-of-the-mill white button mushrooms, nothing special. For each chicken cutlet you serve, you'll want to cut up two mushrooms. So if you're cooking two cutlets from one chicken breast, you'll want four mushrooms. Slice each mushroom into 6 to 8 pieces. And because we'll be cooking these mushrooms down and adding them to the dish at the end, you'll want to start off with pretty thick slices. After the mushrooms are prepped, heat up some oil in a nonstick pan over medium-high heat. They typically use safflower oil at hibachi restaurants, but vegetable or canola oil are both fine, or whatever you have on hand. After the oil is hot, add the mushrooms and a sprinkle of salt and cook until the mushrooms are done to your liking. You'll just want to make sure they've given up all their liquid and are completely cooked. After you're done, put the mushrooms in a container and set aside. For the chicken, start by seasoning each fillet with kosher salt. Then heat up some oil in a nonstick pan over medium-high heat. After the oil is hot, add the chicken to the pan. Cook on one side until it has a nice sear, which should be about 3 to 5 minutes. Then flip the fillets over and cook them until you have a nice sear on the second side, another 3 to 5 minutes. After the second side is cooked, remove the cutlets from the pan and place them on a plate lined with the paper towel. We're going to rest the meat for about 3 to 5 minutes. This will let some of the juices redistribute a little better than just cutting them while they're on the heat like they do at the restaurant. After the meat has rested, cut each fillet into long strips. Then make cuts perpendicular to the strips. This will make you small cubes of chicken. By waiting to dice the chicken until after it is seared instead of when it's raw, you not only improve the flavor, but you're able to more easily make precise cuts. Now wipe out your pan and return it to medium heat. Then put your cut chicken in the hot pan. Toss in the mushrooms and add about 1 tablespoon of garlic butter. If you want to know how to make the hibachi garlic butter, I'll link to the video at the end. Stir until the garlic butter has melted and coated the chicken and the mushrooms. Then sprinkle in a bit of kosher salt and some cracked black pepper to taste. Kill the heat and squeeze the juice of 1/4 of a lemon over the top of the chicken. Then add some sesame seeds and give a good stir. The dish is ready to be served right now, but you'll just want to hit it with a bit more sesame seed for garnish. This method should yield an even better, more consistent result than you can get at any Japanese steakhouse for a fraction of the cost.
If you'd like to learn how to make the hibachi garlic butter, check out this video. And if you'd like to learn how to make some of the other recipes they use at Japanese steakhouses, check out this playlist. Thanks for watching. See you next time.